Hi there! Welcome back to the Burrows! My name is Thor, but I am known here in the Burrows as the CollecThor. Now, you may be wondering, what are the things that I collect to earn the nickname? I collect and store a bunch of different conductors and insulators of electricity, which might be in need by my friend, the electrician, to help with the electricity maintenance of the burrows. Let's check out my storage collection room. Oh, look what I got here. A spoon made out of silver. Silver is an example of a conductor of electricity. But first, what is a conductor of electricity, you might ask? Conductors of electricity are materials, objects, or substances that allow electric current to flow through them. Some examples that I have here are copper wires, an aluminium tube, a spring made of iron, and a silver spoon. These objects are all made of metal, because all metals are conductors of electricity. There are also non-metals that can conduct electricity, like carbon on the tip of pencils and the seawater. That's why it is dangerous to go for a swim in the open sea while there is a thunderstorm with lightning. However, not all metals are good conductors of electricity. Some metals are better conductors of electricity than the other. Let's try it out and compare between the aluminium tube and the iron spring. Let's go! Okay, back to the living room. You may be wondering what this is on the table. This is what I call the test bench, which is just an open circuit. The gap that you see here in the circuit is where I can put an object to test if the object is a conductor or insulator of electricity. Let's test the iron spring first. As you can see, the bulb lit up. The spring made of iron causes the open circuit to become a closed circuit. This allows electric current to flow through the bulb, causing the bulb to light up. Now, let's test the aluminium tube and compare the difference. Well, look at that! The bulb lights up brighter now. This shows that aluminium is a better conductor of electricity and allows more electric current to flow through it, causing the bulb to light up brighter. But on the other hand, since iron is a poorer conductor of electricity and allows less electric current to flow through it, this causes the bulb to be dimmer. Alright, let's get back to my storage room and check out what else I have in my storage. Okay, let's see here. I've got here a ruler made of plastic, which is an insulator of electricity. Insulators of electricity are the materials, objects, or substances that do not allow electric current to flow through them. Some other examples of insulators of electricity that I have here is a wooden spatula, a rubber band, an oven mitten which is made of fabric, and a glass. Why don't we try some of these to see how they work in my test bench? Let's go! Back with the test bench. Let's try the wooden spatula or the plastic ruler or even the rubber band. And the bulb doesn't light up. Since wood, plastic and rubber do not allow electric current to flow through them, this will cause the circuit to still be an open circuit. Thus, no electric current will be able to flow through the light bulb, preventing it from lighting up. As such, These materials that are insulators of electricity are ideal for making tools used when we work with electricity or circuits to prevent ourselves from getting electrocuted. Just like this pair of rubber gloves that I'm wearing right now. And there you go! That sums up the conductors and insulators of electricity. I hope you enjoyed checking out my collection. Bye!
Thank you for watching, and I hope you have enjoyed this video. Found this video useful? Give us a thumbs up. And check out more by clicking the links here. You can also subscribe to our channel for more interesting videos. Until next time, stay curious inside and limitless outside. Bye!